Alrighty, welcome to 7 Days to Die. It is a voxel-based zombie apocalypse survival game. Basically where you can use the environment, use loot to find and or craft weapons and or bases to protect yourself from zombie hordes. The environment is fully destructible. Ground, trees, houses, everything. And constructible. So let's just do a first day in. There is a day and night cycle, and the night cycle is when the zombies become more dangerous. They're dangerous in the day, except that they move slowly and walk slowly. But at night, they start sprinting everywhere, and with the added bonus of you can't see them. So the first steps are going to be to craft some simple tools, find somewhere to hold up for the evening, and reinforce it. And then while doing that, kind of plan for more permanent base making, et cetera, et cetera. Build and grow from there. It can be done single player. It's more fun, of course, cooperatively. So, anyhow, let's get right to it here. Survival. There's only one game world. Currently, there's only one map. Difficulty, more or less normal. Okay, let's go ahead and start. The screen is self-explanatory. Okay, so you can tell right off they dropped me into the winter biome, and let's do a little organization around the map, around the screen here. You see on the lower left-hand side, there's a mini-map there, and surrounding the mini-map, on the left side up, is with the green is your food level, and below is your hydration level. To the upper right side of that, with a little heart in there, is your health, and below that your stamina. You will have to eat food and drink water, or drink fluids here to survive. And if we hit the M key, it shows the map, and shows where we're at right there. Outside of the map, this is radiation zones. If you go in there, you'll die very quickly. You see show buildings and locations. Where the map isn't absolutely huge. It's big enough. It's plenty big. So drop that. Down along the lower side of the screen is your belt, where you have the items that are quickest in reach. Of course, reachable by the number keys. And hit the I for inventory. This is your crafting screen, and this is your backpack inventory. And the crafting system, such that it'll tell you, for example, if you want to make a barbed club, it tells us we need sticks laid on this pattern with some scrap iron. Character screen. Oops. Character screen, protection stats, friends. Let's go ahead and exit out of that. You see the little green dots on the mini-map there to the left. Those are zombies that have not detected me yet, so I shall kind of move away from them. During the daytime, you can walk ahead of them. So a lot of lootable items. Got some food. Scrap, junk. Now, I'm not sure if you're going to be able to see it, but there's these little, like a radial wavy line thing exuding. That's because I'm carrying venison stew, and that's the smell range. So how to get rid of that real quick. Go ahead and drop the venison stew there. I'm going to go ahead and eat it. Right click. nothing left for the zombies to detect. As you can tell, zombies like to make a lot of noise. Oh, he detects me. Kill ya. Looks like you got a couple crawlers. Okay, I need something a little bit better, so I'm going to pick up a rock. Some grass. More grass. Boy, they're definitely on me. Blueberries. Food. Holding the E key down to pick stuff up. Lots of angry things around here. No way. Wildlife. They're usually aggressive. That should be plenty to make some good stuff here. Now, stones. See, if you're not sure if you can craft it, just drop it in the middle and see if you can scrap it or immediately craft it into something. So, first thing I'm going to make is I'm going to make a tool. I have a general purpose tool, which we can find here. And then, let's see, we want to make a stone axe. And it tells you exactly how to make that. Well, first I need to turn some of this grass into grass fibers. See, it doesn't matter which recipe I pick up, or plant fibers, rather. Fibers. I see I still have the recipe pulled up, so I'll right click to drop one. One stick. One sharp stone. That'll get me a stone axe. With a stone axe, I could break rocks, I could chop trees, I could chop zombies if I so please. I think I'll do this persistent nag over here. Lumberjack ones. These guys are a little bit tougher. Yeah. it to go away. As I sprint is holding down the left shift. Search the car here. Good. I'm hoping for some scrap iron. Just about everything is useful. I don't see anything on the mini-map. I know this building usually has some pretty good loot in it. Hopefully I can get something worthwhile. The zombies will start breaking through rocks to get at you. Alright. That's fine. Let's see where they're breaking. Oh, there it is. Stuff that'll give me some fragments. This would be book. Iron. More junk. Busting through that. Thank you. will die if you keep hitting him in the body, but it takes much fewer shots if you aim for the head. Okay, this is what I was going for. Any kind of a safe is good. I'm watching the time and day up in the upper left-hand corner. Blueprint for iron gloves, sawed-off shotgun, shotgun shell, shotgun. Okay. Searching the cabinets for some food. E key, E takes. Shopping here, picks up a cloth. One of the nasty things about zombies, once they shoot you inside of a building, and even though it's daytime, they're just completely dark, they start sprinting. Getting fast. I got my inventory is full. So let's start scrapping some stuff down here. So, for example, we have an air filter. Will give me scrap, 3 scrap irons. Okay, like so. Hubcap, I saw one there. It'll give me a couple scrap irons. Good. Cowboy hat, dropped on my head, and you'll see it'll give me some stats here. It gives me a little bit of protection. Said better than nothing. Crafting tin can. I don't think. Yeah, I need several tin cans for it to give you anything. Scrap brass, and you can probably guess what they use for forging shell casings. Just kind of run through all this, clear out some room in the inventory without really throwing anything away. Now the moldy bread, what it is good for. For creating antibiotics, and the reason why we want antibiotics is because if you are hit by a zombie, there's a chance that you will be infected. So I think I'm going to put the fire axe there, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to chop down a couple trees, and I'll see if I can reinforce them. Not really. But anyway, in this building, small rocks, so I have plans for that. Might as well get some wood. Pick those up because I don't want zombies hitting those and exploding, making big holes everywhere. Some logs. stack. Some stacks go to 10, some go to 4, some go to 500. So. Okay, so it logs. Okay, you'll see these little boulder formations everywhere. So what we'll do for that, gladly we got a pickaxe. If we didn't have a pickaxe, we could still use our stone axe, but it would take a little bit longer. Hold the E key down. This contains usually different kinds of my inventory is full again. So for example, I've got all kinds of small stones. I have some iron fragments. And see, I'm probably hungry, so I'll cat food. Picked up some nitrate powder and some coal, lumps of coal. Okay, so I think I got no room. How about if I eat some soup? Clearing out some inventory room without really wasting anything. And what else do I have here? Well, I can read my schematics, so I'll just so you hold it and then right click. Unfortunately, it doesn't tell you which one, the name of the one. So I'll do this one, Ammunition Nation. Cleared out the space inventory. And what else? Oh, I was going to pick some of these yellow flowers. These things are good for you make tea. But so anyway, okay. I think I've got everything I need to set up a base camp. This building is as good as any. Iron door to it. It's already got a hole down here. What do I need? Nice thing is you can pick it right back up. So it's kind of a temporary thing. So I'll do with the logs, since I have some open room here. Drop a couple of them in the crafting. Give me some wood planks. And for example, to upgrade the windows to make them a little bit more secure, you need wood planks in the inventory. Switch over to your stone axe, and then if you right click on a window, see that? Adds a little bit more protection there. Just take some. Make sure it's not going to take time. The windows. I'm not sure exactly how protective it is, but we'll find out. And all my anyway, that's just to kind of show you how to kind of do a little reinforcing on your if you're just taking over a house for a night. Now, water is another important thing. So you notice I have some empty glass jars. I've got two sets of them actually. One water source, as distasteful as it sounds. So you're holding an empty jar, you hold it over a toilet. I'll do the other stack here. Okay. Ooh, a ladder which goes up to the roof. And we have some stuff up here to loot as well. For the meantime, let's see if I can block that or not. Possibly not. Let's throw that there just for fun anyway. So, that's something else I can do. Kind of cabin wood. And I can attach it to the edge of the couch there, which kind of blocks that hole. Will give me 4 blocks. Awesome. So, let's quick do this stuff. Yep, scrap fire. Let's do that now. Where's this? Feathers. Use those to make crossbow bolts. And yes, crossbows can be crafted. Crossbows are actually very, very good at the game. So we got a critter might be on the inside of the garage area. More feathers in the room. Moldy bread, which doesn't do me good until I get a beaker. So let's kind of go over here. Did I get that? Nope. Bird's nest. Okay, so actually I got enough to make some crossbones and crossbow bolts. So get this one here. Oh, I did not. Lots of feathers. Excellent. Okay, so I'm going to kind of set up over here this way in the middle of the building. Somewhere up here, I think. So now, I'm going to set up camp in preparation for my first night. It's a little earlier than what needs to be done, but this is just a demonstration purpose only. So, let's see, where would it be? It would be food and, under food and cooking, campfire. So it just tells me I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 small stones. Place it. Number 9, select it. There's my campfire. Now, if you notice, the water I scooped out of the toilet is called bottled murky water. And you see by the red, it has negative effects on your health, wellness, stamina, but it gives you hydration. So if you're absolutely desperate, you can drink it. But, ooh, you know what? I probably not going to be able to do it. But we'll see. We'll see. So we have the campfire, and let's see if we have anything. Make a cooking pot? No, I cannot. Have to find a cooking pot. So that kind of shoots that down. So basically, if we want to, if you do an E on the campfire, put your cooking pot here, you fuel, which is anything that's burnable, and another window will pop up here, that's where you put your bottled water, or murky water, and it turns it into bottled water. So, next item is, when I gathered up all those cloth fragments, I'm going to see if I can make a sleeping bag. Is trying to remember which category it all is all under. It's food, cooking, building, perhaps? Miscellaneous. us that by these white numbers here, it means you have materials to make some of these things. There we go, sleeping bag. For some reason it's under building. So, tells me I need the cloth put in this pattern, these cloth fragments put in this pattern. Left. And I'm going to place the sleeping bag like so. By placing a sleeping bag, that basically creates a spawn point for if my avatar is killed, this is where I will respawn at. Okay, now some little better melee weapons here. My favorite is the spiked club, which is, as far as the striking instrument, it's the most powerful. So here's a pattern. Scrap iron. That's why I was so keen on getting scrap iron. Here's my spike club. But you can start a fire anyway, just to accept that as something combustible. So I can throw. It doesn't know how much time it uses for each piece. Different wooden items. Gives a different amount of time. Nice little decor, lights up the night really nice. Zombies don't seem to be attracted by lights that much, but they're more attracted by sound and smell. Let's see what else. Cowboy hat, I don't really need. So, go ahead and toss that. Now, it's there on the ground, so if you hit the little E by accident, it'll suck up in your inventory. It's kind of annoying when you're trying to get rid of something. It will eventually disappear. Now, let's, for the good part, let's do crossbow. I don't have enough sticks. Not a problem. So, what I'll do is I'll create some wood planks. Cut them down. Exactly the number I need. So, crafting down the planks and the sticks. Now I can make my crossbow. And my two plant fibers. Craft the grass, crafted the grass into plant fibers. Especially when ammunition is not plentiful. There's always materials around to make crossbow and crossbow bolts. My crossbow. And I don't have any sticks left, so. So I'll make as many sticks as possible. Now, here's the nice part about this. While this is crafting, the I key, it's still continuing to craft. It doesn't slow you down or anything like that. So you can still kind of run around and take a look around. See way off in the distance, I can hear them. Hear them moaning occasionally. We can. I got one sharp stone, so let's crap down the rest of my stones. most I can make is 9. I'll throw them all on there anyway. It's not going to eat all of them. It'll have leftover. Crossbow bolts. It's not required, but I like to put them down in my bar. Just to, lets me know how many I have left. Back. He's not going to need them, so I'm just going to drop them. Okay, let's bring up my crossbow. First time you bring up a new weapon, you have to reload it, and that's R. Okay, again, a single headshot will kill a zombie with a crossbow. See a little red dot there? Missed. That reloads. Been close enough for a headshot. Right click does the close aim. Otherwise you get the crosshairs. I could always go down and break up some more stones so I can make some more bolts, etc., etc. Spike club. 2 hits in the head on a zombie, any zombie, it will drop them. As opposed to, 5 hits with the stone axe? Probably about 12 hits with your fist. So, that's all I got to show you. I do have a server running, so of course I got more advanced build up there. So, there it is. Hope it looks interesting to you. Alright, talk to you later.